Welcome back to eCircuit, guys. Remember to send in your comments, requests, and we'll be sampling them at the end of the show. So you can like our Facebook pages, eCircuit, Instagram, and Twitter. And remember, siku like peke yake, tuna share. So in studio right now, I have one of the baddest, and I mean the baddest, dancehall artist. You may know him from one of his hit songs that made him break out. In Aitwa, they call me Sugar, they call me Daddy. Yeah, I bet everyone knows that song and many more that struck out Kijua right now. I'm talking about the one and only Serone. Welcome, Serone, and thank you so much for joining us.
Thank you so much for having me. Mm-hmm. Yeah, it's an honor, man.
Yeah, how are
Bless you? Bless up. I'm good, man. Uh-huh. I'm excited. Mm-hmm. Yeah, and let's do this.
Yeah. So I want us to talk a little bit about your musical career. Okay. Just an overview.
All right. So I started music from, I started as a songwriter. I was in the background mm-hmm. just writing songs for other people. But for 2015, that's when I decided to go out as a solo artist.
Yeah.
And I did Sugar. Mm-hmm. But for me, my goal was always to do worldwide music. I believe the world is too big.
Which is worldwide, by the way.
Yeah, yeah. For me, my music, I believe it's great and it's international. So that mm-hmm. was always been my goal from day one. Mm-hmm. So I did Sugar, it got bigger. And then, that's been my musical journey. Worked mm-hmm. on different singles. And right now, I'm working on my debut album uh-huh. And a tour. We did a tour last year.
Yeah.
We were in Kakuma, Narok, Nakuru, Machakos, so many places. And just trying to see what people like and what people prefer in terms of music. Mm-hmm. And And among all that, I also worked with an artist by the name of Leo from Austria.
Yeah.
And the song got big. And that's why we're here today.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
We were actually supposed to be with Leo and you today, but he apologized for not being here today because he had some personal issues, which we accepted his apology. So the song that you did with Leo, Mamacita.
Yeah.
So how did that collaboration come in?
Well, interesting thing, music just cuts across everywhere. So Leo was in Ukunda in a club mm-hmm. and he was dancing. And he had the song playing, and everywhere he went, he was like, "Oh, who's that artist?"
Mm-hmm. So, which song?
They call me Sugar. Ah, they call me Daddy. So, yeah.
And that explains music is international.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. So he heard it, he sajammed it, and then he come show it's Serone, mm-hmm. and then he hit me up. So he sent me a inbox on IG, and then I gave him my email, and then we started talking. His team talked to my team, and before you know it, he came all the way to Nairobi, went to the studio. Mm-hmm. We did the audio. Then we went back to the coast, we did the video, and then he launched it in mm-hmm. Vienna, Germany, and basically in Europe and South America, and the song blew up, yeah? Mm-hmm. So right now he's here in the country trying to spread the love mm-hmm. to the Kenyan fans, and mm-hmm. it was amazing. It's mm-hmm. still amazing, and it's a work in progress and a learning process as well. Mm-hmm.
So how was Mamacita received by your fans and also his fans in Europe?
Well, the fans in Europe, from what I've seen, I get a lot of Instagram followers from elsewhere. So many of his fans were like, I love the vibe. It was more of trying mm-hmm. to bring the two worlds together. I believe as a musician, it's not doing what is comfortable for you every day. It's to challenge mm-hmm. you. It's to throw musicians in one room mm-hmm. and see what happens. And we wanted to create something that would also represent from both worlds. So mm-hmm. the reception from his country was crazy because mm-hmm. the video was done in Ukunda. The natives were there.
Yeah.
The vixen was African. Mm-hmm. So for that was really amazing. For my fans, they were more like, oh, Serone, now you're singing again. You're trying. You know, my fans really loved it. And they're like, yo, why are you not bringing the song here? Why are you not pushing the song here? But now
why
I was
not?
Like, the time is going to come. Uh-huh. And the time is now. So mm-hmm. now Leo is in the country and we're trying to let people know more about the story of how he done it mm-hmm. and do the tour here in Africa and also do similar in Europe. So mm-hmm. I'm honored, man.
So we're talking about your fans saying that you're not promoting the song.
Yep.
You're not bringing the song to them.
Yep.
So I want to tell them he is bringing the song to you because he's here today. I mean,
yeah, for the very first time live on
Y2. Yeah.
Yeah.
So we were talking with you and this is a discussion that has been ongoing. And I think now I don't want to say it's getting tired,
uh-huh.
but people just need to act on the Play KE thing and just not talk about it.
True.
So what's your take on that? And what are you doing as an artist?
Well, interesting thing, as a musician, you usually get one talent and then God gives you more. Mm-hmm. So I'm also a filmmaker. The video, yeah, Mamacita, yeah. I did the video. I did a short film. I'm working on a movie. But I've been in the discussion with other musicians. I've done a song with Kolo and Juakali. And before the recording session, we were just talking about what can we do rather than just talk about it. So we came up with an interesting idea. As a filmmaker, I'm doing like an offer to all my fellow musicians. And we discussed like what is the minimum budget that a musician can have for a video. And most of my friends were like, 50,000 is minimum for you to have a decent video. So we said, okay, fine, for 50,000 let's multiply that for three videos. So we're doing like 50,000 three videos. And then
quality videos,
so shooting with a red camera, drone and all that, so it's pretty amazing. Then Gitz, who was in the room with me, has a studio. It's called Antioch Studios. If you watch my vlogs, I did a song there. He has state-of-the-art equipment. So he was like, okay, fine, also I'm gonna be part of this, and I'm gonna do audio sessions for 1,000 shillings. So if you have 1,000 shillings, you can book a session and record your song. If you have 50,000. And the interesting thing is, now we're getting more publicists are coming on. So we're trying to make it more like a campaign. I have a friend from Canada who has a portal, Play Kenyan Music. So it's a website. So if you have your music, just search playkenyanmusic.com, submit the music there. He's going to work on like a networking where he plays Kenyan music to the world. So as we're doing the tour in Germany. No, for free.
Now
that's for him. It's for the project that we're working on. So if you're watching and you're interested, holler at me on Instagram. I am underscore Serene.
So all the artists out there, this is a one-time deal that you cannot afford to miss out. So, but of course, you have to have talent.
At the end of the day, it's not just anything. When you're in the studio, like for example, Kolo is going to be around the studio. If you find him, there's so many artists. Tulopa is also around the building. So we're trying to make musicians also... Because people complain, ah, he's mzingi, he's a ujinga and all that. But at the end of the day, the new generation, that's the future. Technically, they're literally the future. So if you don't nurture the sound that they're creating, the sheng that they're talking about, if you hate on it, then you're killing it. So if you're saying you're playing Kenya music and you're not supporting the new generation, then you're just an hypocrite.
Okay, I have just one question for you on the new generation. It's not about the sheng. What about the video, like dirty dancing, the language they are talking, you know, that is the main problem actually in my perspective.
In your perspective.
Well,
for me, what I think is, if you understand that it's dirty language, that means you also talk like that. You know, it's not Arabic. You can't go like, what are they saying? If you understand, that means you relate. So it's just a matter of like the older generation, I feel the more like, so they're gonna come in and sing a nice song and pretend they don't talk about those things. But this young generation,
what about the younger people?
You'd be surprised, that is what people go through on a daily basis. When they wake up, when they're listening to music, they don't listen to spiritual music, they listen to that music. So whatever goes in them is what comes out. And that's why the music is blowing up, because they are real. And I think as a musician, that is the most important thing. If you sing about a girlfriend who broke up with you, and if it's true, the song is gonna be legit. So most of the artists kind of have like their gospel, but they don't feed gospel to them. So the songs that come out, they're not gospel. But the young generation, the guy who was here, that's what they listen to. I mean, when they're vibing in the club, in the studios, that is it. So when they translate it into the music, it's pure realness. And then the music is real. And then the numbers start coming in. And then the people go like, oh, why are they doing this? Why are they doing this? But at the end of the day, it's about being real.
Yeah, people stop pretending.
Yes, just be real. If you're a dancehall artist, be a true dancehall artist. If you wake up in the morning, smoke weed, talk about that. That's what you go through. Don't start talking about God and you're not with God. I mean, be real.
And cars and money. And
don't talk about, yo, I'm balling, I'm a dad, and you're single. You know, I mean, it would be fake. You know, if you watch a movie like Straight Out of Compton, there's a line where Dr. Dre told Eazy-E, like, cruising down. He was like, yo, you can't sing this line. You don't have that car. Let Eazy-E do it, because he owns that car. So when someone says, like, yo, I'm balling. And that's why you see, for me, I feel like the new generation and secular music is more more mm-hmm. impactful
yeah.
is because what we sing about mm-hmm. is what we go through.
Yeah.
If I say, yo, Mama Sita.
That is what is happening.
Yeah, like Leo, when we were singing Mama Sita, mm-hmm. we were jamming with the girls in the studio, you know, we're in the beach. Uh-huh. That was real. So yeah. when we look at the music, that's why he's coming to Kenya.
Mm-hmm.
He wants to feel the real Kenyan vibe, mm-hmm. hang out with the real Kenyan girls,
yes.
hang out with the real producers, mm-hmm. work with the real artists, so that when he comes to the song, mm-hmm. it's real.
Mm-hmm.
It's not fake.
Mm-hmm.
He won't start saying, ah, Kenya, kuna matata. He'll be like, yo.
That's
you know, he's like, rada. You know? So, yeah, that's my okay. 2 cents about uh-huh. it. Yeah.
So, people say that there's no content.
Uh-huh.
No content in Kenya. So, you disagree totally with that.
I
because if someone
content,
can
yeah.
contact you all the way from Europe and yeah. talk to you and tell you, I want to do a collab with you, then
true.
That means there's talent.
Exactly.
Yeah.
And I'm an example of that.
Mm. Yes. So, talking about your music,
uh-huh.
there's this diss track,
uh-huh.
Red Sun diss track. Yes.
Yeah.
Uncharted Waters.
Uh-huh.
Why did you do a diss track for Red Sun?
Wow. So, last year, if you have no copy, we were in the studio. So many things were going on. And I was trying to come out as a dancehall artist,
mm-hmm.
as an Afro dancehall artist, because we have a festival in Colombia called Dancehall Paradise,
mm-hmm.
and they're taking so many African artists right now,
mm-hmm.
and Jamaican artists.
Yes.
So we were trying to create that vibe, and in the process, so many of my fans were like, oh, yo, man, we got this artist in your country, and yo, he's launching an album, but I can't find it. I'm like, okay. Oh, yo, can't you do this song with this guy? You said he was in this country, but I was there. He wasn't there.
Mm-hmm.
So at the end of the day, we were like, okay, fine. The dancehall track was called Bring It Back.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, as we were discussing, it's about legit. If
yeah.
you talk about, if I say I'm doing a song with an Austrian, it should be real.
Mm-hmm.
If I'm coming here, I'm talking about something, it should be real. So for me, it was me calling me out and mm-hmm. going like, yo, bro, you need to bring it back. Dancehall music, when we were growing up, was the biggest genre. Kuna ngoma flani ya hip hop na sabanga kupita sijui milango za dancehall ni jasho. Back in the day, dancehall was it. And I feel
yes.
every musician has a role to play.
Mm-hmm.
And Red Sun and his generation never played that role. Because
mm-hmm.
if you look at Nigerian music, Two-Face did his part and then he left.
Yeah.
Another artist came and picked it from where he was. So if Red Sun had a responsibility to take music to this level
mm-hmm.
and he didn't, mm-hmm. then he failed.
Mm-hmm.
And for me, I feel it was me calling him out and going like, yo, one of the reasons why people are not playing Kenyan music is because, one, you never mm-hmm. played your part.
Yeah.
Every musician has a role to play. We have a role to mentor the new artist. The older generation have a role. It doesn't have to be sitting down.
Mm-hmm.
It's just you play your role.
I
mean, if you get an opportunity to work with someone personally, do it. And then in your job,
mm-hmm.
like he had a role to push dancehall music to the world.
He
says he's international.
Mm-hmm.
He says he has 5 albums. He doesn't have 1 album published. He's just been lying. And I mean, we could go back all over that.
That is serious.
So listen to the diss track if you think I'm lying. If you're a Red Sun fan,
it has
facts. You know, it's about,
yeah.
it's about facts. It's about calling it out as it is.
Mm-hmm.
That's what's
Did
up.
Did he respond?
Well, he blocked me
mm-hmm.
on Instagram.
Oh, okay.
And then he tried to reach out to our people.
Mm-hmm.
He tried to act like he and his ties a reply. But we know he heard it. But one thing you know, it's about winning the war. It's
yeah.
not about the battle.
Mm-hmm.
So this is just the beginning. At
yeah.
the end of the day, you can only have one
mm-hmm.
dope artist.
Mm-hmm.
You can only have competition.
Mm-hmm.
That through competition is the only way music gets to grow.
Yeah.
We don't have to like each other,
mm-hmm.
but we always have to bring our best. So if
yeah.
you don't bring your best, someone else is going to bring their
mm-hmm.
best. And it is their right to come and say,
and
yo,
you're bringing your best.
I'm better than you, so you should step aside
okay.
and let the people, other people take over.
Mm-hmm. So our topic of discussion today was,
yeah.
What are some of those myths and beliefs that your parents told you? And you came to realize that they were not true when you grew up. Yako ni gani?
Hey, there's this funny one. Ukitembea nje na mwavuli utapigwa shock na lightning.
Oh
you
yeah.
You heard that one?
Yes.
Ukivaa nguo ya red, utapigwa shock. I don't know if it's true. I still haven't, but sijaona kama
umepigwa
shock.
Yeah.
Yeah, kuna hiyo. Alafu pia kuna ile ukienda coast, ukiwa mtoi utachomwa na joke albino. I don't know, my parents used to tell me that so that ndo tusiende trips Mombasa. And see tulikuwa tunaogopa, so we grew up in trips zikaisha.
Okay.
Funny, interesting fact, yeah.
So where can people find you on social media?
Yo, you can find me on Instagram, Serenay. I am _ Serenay. Facebook, I am _ Serenay. Twitter as well. Yeah, check out my page. You can also follow me on YouTube, Serenay Music. Like my page, subscribe. I'm doing music videos. I'm doing vlogs, weekly vlogs. We'll have a vlog about this next week. Get to know what happened behind the scenes. Anyway, so that's where you can find me.
Yeah.
Yep.
And remember, he has that offer and his team. You know, 3 videos for $50,000. I bet for an artist that's a big deal.
Yep.
So don't forget about that. Then once again, I want to... Leo sent his apology and will be a video explaining why he did not make it to come to the interview, and we will be watching it.
And then check out Mamacita as well.
Yes.
Leo featuring Serenay. It has over 500,000 views on YouTube. Check it out. Check out Leo's music as well. He's done music with Shaggy, LL Cool J, Jean Paul.
He's a big pop
artist. He said when he comes back to Nairobi, he's going to be here on Y254.
Yeah.
So check out the video as well, Mamacita. Serenay featured by Leo Abere.
Yeah.
Papa Leo.
Yes, this is Leo Abere. Unfortunately, I couldn't come. Yeah, sometimes life is hard. I have some private problems. My girlfriend is in hospital. And I hope you understand that I did not come to your interview, but big up to you and big up to Kenya. I love Kenya. It's for me the best country after Austria, and I loved Kenyan music, and I hope to see you again soon. Bye.